we want to beat the market, so we just add to that investment, and you wind up adding to a losing trade. Now, Teresa, on the Cycle Value newsletter, we have about 40 or 50 household name stocks, and we have the name of the stock, the symbol, the investment cycle, the primary cycle, and then our current cycle strategy, and then we have the company website. So on the newsletter, you can just, if you're not familiar with the company, you can click on the website, and then you can learn a little bit about the fundamentals of the company. When I was a young executive at the Wall Street firm, Loeb Rosen Company, which was the third largest brokerage firm in the world, I would had the permission to go down into the research department in the filing area. And they had 6 or 10 people. Their full-time job was cutting out articles in the Wall Street Journal or the New York Times or the business section of any newspaper and putting them within the file. So if you asked for a file on ABC, you would have the file and you would have all the newspaper clippings that had to do with that particular stock. Now, of course, we have the internet, and you just have to go on to the internet and you put in the symbol and you have every article of all the news and everything else that you want about that particular stock. But you know what I learned a long time ago? That all the information that I read 40 years ago with those clippings, or all the information that you can read online, is not worth anything, because it's news that has already been reflected within the stock price. Okay, so the biggest mistake that people make is what they think they're watching TV. They think the analyst that's giving a buy recommendation is only talking to them, rather than the millions of people that may be calling the broker at the same time to buy or sell, you know, the particular recommendation that was being made. So what I've learned a long time ago is that reading an annual report, listening, reading stuff online and so on is really a brainwash. You're brainwashing yourself to like the stock that you're considering buying by all different ways, rather than the logic that you need. That's why I use cycle analysis, because the cycle analysis doesn't have any emotion. We don't care about the news, and I think our cycles anticipate fundamental news ahead of time. Okay, so you can go on and you can look at any stock and so on, but from the list of all these household name stocks, let's go through whichever stocks that. Here's the question. Which stocks do you think are going to be around for the next 10 years that you're familiar with?
Okay. Netflix.
Go in alphabetical order.
Order. Okay, from the top. All right. I would think Apple Computer would be.
Okay, you're skipping Alphabet, which is a new name for Google.
Oh yeah, I mean I see that right here.
But you're not.
And Google is huge. Yes, I believe that would be around for quite a while.
Right. Would you have an objection to investing in Google?
No, I would not.
Okay. How about the next one is Amazon?
Amazon, the same. I use Amazon. Many people use Amazon that I know. So yes, I'd be confident.
Okay. Then you said Apple Computer. Okay.
Apple,
and then what's the next one going in alphabetical order?
Chipotle.
Okay.
Because I really like their concept.
Yeah. Unfortunately, the stock dropped about 30 points because of some Ebola scare in the last couple of days. But that's an example of, is this a buy opportunity or is there more selling to come? Okay, what's next?
Intercontinental Exchange.
Okay, what do you know about them?
Only what I just read from using your newsletter.
Okay.
And they are in a position, it seems, to explode on the currency exchange market throughout the world.
Very good. Okay, what's the next one?
Netflix would be my next pick.
Okay, very good. Cerise, we're going to stop there because I think we're almost out of time. But what we want to tell the listening audience is that from time to time, I'm going to be doing a program later on this week talking about the discipline rules of investing and so on and so forth. And then I would be speaking with you off the air about some of these disciplines and how they are best for you. Okay, and then we would have you back on the program as a progress report. And as I promised you, in about 2 or 3 months, when you come on the program, you'll be telling our listening audience what stocks they should buy. So,
wonderful.
Teresa, I appreciate you being with us. Thank you so much. Until the next time, we'll see you then.
Thank you.
You've been listening to Buy, Sell, or Hold with Peter Bruno. With over 50 years of background and experience in the financial industry, Peter advises individual, corporate, and institutional clients throughout the United States. For additional information about his original and proprietary research, call his direct toll-free number, 1-800-592-5578, or visit his homepage at peterbrunomedia.com. Nothing said within this program shall be considered a solicitation or an offer to buy, and any investment decisions should be reviewed and subject to one's individual investment objectives. Peter Bruno's Buy, Sell, or Hold is heard daily from 4:30 to 5 and streamed live online at peterbrunomedia.com. Plus, there you will find webcasts and more. That's peterbrunomedia.com.
The opinions expressed on the preceding sponsored program were strictly those of its hosts, guests, and callers, and not necessarily those of this station, its staff, management, or sponsor.
Tune in for laughs and surprises with The Boca Show, Sundays at 4, only on 1470 WNN.
If an individual student athlete or team wins a high school state championship, it's an amazing thing.
And it goes in! It goes in!
It's also just the icing on the cake. That's because young people in Florida who participate in education-based athletics are already winners. Studies show that win or lose, participation helps to impart skills they can use to enjoy greater success in other areas of their lives. School sports teach the benefits of teamwork, the value of self-motivation, and the importance of accountability. They also help to foster stronger work habits and higher levels of self-esteem. In other words, the true value of school sports can't be measured in terms of wins or losses. If an individual or team goes to state, it's an incredible accomplishment. But regardless of the outcome, today's student athletes are already destined to go far. School sports, a winning part of a complete education. This message presented by the Florida High School Athletic Association and the Florida Interscholastic Athletic Administrators Association.
Christopher Kennedy Lawford tells how he found the way out of drug use.
If you try to control addiction, it will beat you. It will absolutely beat you. I've had that experience myself. What happened to me was a moment of clarity, a moment of grace, a moment of profound transformation that I can only describe as God as I understand it. And that came into my life because I had been beaten down to a point where I was open enough and surrendered enough to allow grace to come into my life. That's what happened to me. The greatest gift in my life has been the ability to surrender, to give up. Because out of that comes unbelievable understanding and unbelievable compassion and unbelievable gifts.
Those overcoming addiction can use your understanding and compassion. For more help, go to findinghopeinrecovery.com from the Mennonite Churches.
Talk 1470, WWNN, Pompano Beach, Boca Raton, Miami, Fort Lauderdale.
AM 1470, WNN, with more of what you need to know. Start your day with the Steve Kane Show, Monday through Friday, 6 to 9 a.m. on South Florida's Health and Wealth Network, AM 1470, WNN.
Do you know of anyone who lives with pain or has high blood pressure, diabetes, or asthma? Do seizures or any other types of illness run in the family? Then this message could be very important to you. RAIN International introduces Soul, a new energized drink that revitalizes and detoxifies naturally. Soul offers you the opportunity to feel better and get help with many illnesses that may have overtaken your body. Visit their website at myrainlife.com/God blessings and get all the information you need to let RAIN Solution heal your soul. If you want to talk to Soul, call 954-696-8330 and begin your steps to better health. RAIN International also has job opportunities that can change your life in 7 different categories. Call today and get a healthy body, a healthy mind, and create a healthy bank account. 954-696-8330. Call today and let's make it rain.
You get your monthly mutual fund or 401k statements, look at the bottom line and say,
is that it?
If after all these years your investments are still making diddly squat, do it yourself. Learn to trade stocks, options, futures, and forex at Online Trading Academy in South Florida. Learn in real classrooms where students of all ages are taught how money is made in up, sideways, and down markets using a patented rules-based strategy taught only at Online Trading Academy. All instructors are certified, currently trade, and profitable. They show you what they do every day. Most students trade with a couple of $1,000s. Since 1997, Online Trading Academy has taught over 100,000 students. You can do this. Tired of low returns? Call now and reserve 2 seats to a free class to see how the banks and institutions trade. Seating is limited. Call 954-668-2510. 954-668-2510. That's 954-668-2510.
You say you need to lose weight for the holidays or just to stay healthy. Nothing seems to be working except frustration. The wait is over. Order your organic detox tea and resolution drops from the Weight Is Over company and start feeling better by shedding pounds. Not all detox systems are the same. Listen to those who have used the tea with fantastic results. Visit her website, totallifechanges.com/4219711, to get all the information you need to feeling better. Drink 2 cups a day, and you too can lose 5 pounds in 5 days. Call today, 954-696-8330, and listen to testimonials about proper weight loss using the tea. Ask about the opportunity to earn $50,000 by Christmas with a Total Life Changes business opportunity. Call today, 954-696-8330, and change your life today.
What you want to know. What you need to know.
Talk 1470 WNN.
The opinions expressed on the following sponsored program are strictly those of the host, guests, and callers, and not necessarily those of this station, its staff, management, or sponsors.
Do you have enough light in your life? Are you soaring in the joy around you? Are you stuck and unable to make life happen? Stay tuned for the Rabbi Jenny Show, where you will learn how to bask in the light and find more joy and meaning in life. Call to talk to Rabbi Jenny at 888-565-1470 and email questions and comments at rabbijenny.com. And now, if you're ready, stay tuned for the Rabbi who will light your world on fire, Rabbi Jenny.
Hey, it's Rabbi Jenny. Happy Wednesday, and I am so thrilled to be here. I am resting with you all, my listeners. I am so excited about the portion this week of the Torah, about our guest, and just to be sitting here talking to you for this precious hour. It is my joy. I want to remind you of RabbiJenny.tv. Please contact me on there. Email me if you have any questions or you just want to get some information on classes. Check that out. Check out my Facebook page. Like it, please. Rabbi Jenny Skylark. You can like that. And I'm doing the Twitter and the Instagram and all sorts of stuff. So just hook me with me there. And thank you so much for listening today. And I want to invite, I want to inform you or teach you or tell you something you hear every week if you listen to the Rabbi Jenny Show. And if it is your first week on the show, these are the 2 main ideas that I carry with me in my precious heart for my journey. And I'm passing them on to you. because it is very important to me that you incorporate them into your soul, into who you are, so you can become who you are meant to be. The first one is this: the world is happening for you and not to you. And that is absolutely 100% all of the time, no matter how it looks, feels, smells, tastes, or anything else, okay? Whatever it is happening for you and not to you. And if you want to call me and discuss it, I will help you figure out why. And the second idea is this: you are divine love, light, energy, always expanding, always becoming bigger, better, and brighter, always pushing away those shadows that keep you from shining. And that is why everything's happening for you. So sometimes it hurts a little, but it's just peeling away another layer so you can shine a little bit more in your true power. Our topic today is this: learning to trust. And it is actually, I have to say, my favorite topic this week, my favorite portion this week. I say that because every single letter in the Torah is my favorite. But when I'm studying it, I'm in another place, another time. And I love to introduce to you the scroll and the ideas in it and how it can teach us to live a better life. And right now we are in Chaya Sarah, which is the life of Sarah. Sarah's the wife of Abraham. And if you don't know the story, I'm going to tell you. Because Sarah, I believe Sarah's biggest message, the Sarah inside of us, because we all have a Sarah in us, the Sarah in us is the message is to learn to trust, to wait and to trust. To wait and to trust. And we make messes when we don't wait and we don't trust. So if you're listening today, your message is definitely, it's time to trust and it's time to pause. And if things aren't working out exactly the way that you have been told in your intuition, in your gut, in your soul that they're going to work out, simply waiting is the answer. Don't try to manufacture it. Don't try to make plans, because that's what our girl Sarah did. And let's talk about that, because she created quite a mess. Actually, a whole separate faith came right out of that little mess. So I don't know if it was a mess or intentional, but it was what it was. Sarah's original name in the scroll had three letters, and it was Sarai. Most people don't know that. They think her name was always Sarah, but her name was Sarai with a yud at the end of it, and that is how it would have been pronounced in Hebrew. And that's how she starts out. It's Avram, Abraham, Avram, not Avraham, and Sarai, and they take off into the desert to inherit the earth, according to God. So Sarai is told with her husband that she's going to have a baby, and they're going to, her husband Abraham is going to father all nations. I'm not sure how the words go, but it's a pretty big promise directly from heaven. And so that's why it's about trust, because this message is given and then nothing happens. If you know the story of Abraham and Sarah, you know from last week's show that they don't have a baby for a long, long, long time together. That's how this story works out. But in the meantime, Sarah doesn't trust. Sarah doesn't wait. Sarah makes plans, because she's like us. She's like the rest of us. She's like me. She's like every other human being on the planet who has a mind that can think and can go and has a better idea than the one that they have to wait for. What Sarah does is she makes a plan with her handmaiden, Hagar, whichever way you want to pronounce it. And she decides that it would be better, instead of having a barren wife such as herself, because she's never going to have children because the word of God wasn't accurate, she decides to give her husband, or allow her husband, to lay down with her handmaiden servant Hagar and make a baby. Well, he does, and let's just say in the end she doesn't like it. You know, I mean, I don't know. I mean, maybe that's the human part of us. Like, we think we're doing the right thing, but we don't take into account our emotions and the mess that we're making. So he has his baby, Hagar, with the Hagar, and it's Ishmael. It's a whole other show, because we're not going to talk about that. But what we are going to talk about is the fact that much, much later, Sarai's name changes to Sarah, and her yud at the end of her name changes to a hey. And let me just tell you something. There's a big difference between this letter yud and this letter hey, because yud is a hand. It's our hand. It's all we can produce with our hand and our head, because resh, the middle letter, is our head. So our head and our hand and our human selves, that's all we can create, is these bright ideas that don't involve any trust and any faith. But at the end, when she finally, at I believe 100, maybe she was 100, I think Abraham was 99, have Isaac, her name changes to Sarah, and she changes to a resh and a hey. The letter that appears twice, it means window. It means opening up to the universe and allowing. It means our breath. And so it's our head combined with the universe, the force of nature. So she completely transforms when she once gives birth. But in the meantime, this whole very, very big side story emerges, and she creates a lot of frustration for herself because she doesn't wait. You know, and I say to myself with these stories in Torah that it's there to teach me. It's there to teach me what to necessarily avoid. But for you listeners, it's definitely what's on the mark for this week, because there is something probably in your life right now that you are trying to manufacture a solution to right as we speak. And you are absolutely sure it is a very, very bright idea, and it will make things happen faster than you've ever wanted them to happen, because you just know that this is the way to get it done. And if you're anything like me, you do that all the time. But when we do that, we create messes that we don't even see, because we forget that we're in cooperation with a very kind universe. The energy is always conspiring in ways that we can't see. And when we get in the way, it's not allowed to do what it needs to do for us. I saw a couple movies. You know how I love to tell you about movies. On this subject, I can actually talk about them. And I have some quotes, like I always do. I'm going to pick a quote from Harry Potter, because I did watch Harry Potter with my son this week. And this quote comes at the end of the very last book. And it says, "The last words Albus Dumbledore spoke to the pair of us, Harry is the best hope we have. Trust him." You know, huge trust. Trust him. "To be trusted is a greater compliment than to be loved." George MacDonald. There's a lot of quotes about trust, but trust is very difficult. And the funny thing about trust is once you give it, it's very hard to earn it when it's lost. It's very hard to earn it back. Oh, wait. But there are these movies that I saw. I saw two movies. I saw the movie Truth. Oh my gosh, great movie with Kate Blanchett and Robert Redford. Robert Redford plays a brilliant Dan Rather. Looks nothing like Dan Rather, but sounds like Dan Rather. It's very, very awesome. And in this movie, it's a great movie about trust, because Mary Mapes, I believe is her name, she's a producer for 60 Minutes, who hasn't worked since 2004, but she produces a show right before Bush was elected about him not actually serving and going AWOL in the National Guard. And covering that up. And it's a really controversial story. And, you know, they poke holes in it, and she's basically crucified and can't make news anymore. But the funny thing is this character that she plays and how she battles with her trust of life that she had lost because of her childhood with her father. And so it's like, who are you going to trust? Are you going to trust your heart? Are you going to trust the world? Are you going to put your trust in things that have been untrustworthy? Or are you going to put trust in the universe? Sarah is all about the bigger trust. It's not about the specific human trust. Human people will always fall short because we're human. We always react with our emotions. We always react with our mind. We always react with our limited experiences. But the universe is where we reach out to trust. So how do we do that? You know, one of the things they talk about in this movie, Truth, is that just, you know, her husband keeps trying to tell her, you know, let's go for a walk. Let's go for a walk. Can we go for a walk? And she's so busy in her producing in her busy life, and she doesn't. And then at the end of the movie, when all this has happened and everything's been taken away or stripped away, she says, let's go for a walk. Because when you're walking, you're outside, you're breathing, you're remembering that you're a part of the bigger piece or of the whole. It helps you develop trust. So if you're staying inside a lot, you know, maybe that's the message, to get out and be in nature so you can trust more, like Sarah does in the end. I also watched the movie The Best Exotic Marigold Hotel. Seen it before, but happened to love it. It's one of my favorites, not only for its colors, but just for its major message. And its major message is this. The lead character, the owner of the hotel, he says, the young man says, it's always all right in the end. And if it's not all right, it's not the end. And I just love this little saying because it's true. We're in the process and we want it to be over. But, you know, life is a journey. Life takes time. Sarah's journey had more, she had more to do. She had more to live. She had more to learn before she was ready to give birth to Isaac. There was more for her to do that she might have enjoyed and not been so frustrated about if she wasn't focusing on the fact that she wasn't getting what she wanted when she wanted to please, you know, this vision that she had of this big, you know, fathering the whole our whole people. And the wonderful thing about that story is that we always think in human terms, like, oh, I'm going to father the whole nation. That means I'm going to have 20 kids. Well, no, they just have one. And then from him comes another and another. And then then it's not until Jacob that the 12 tribes emerge and the whole people become apparent. So this is Rabbi Jenny. We're talking about trust, learning to trust in Sarah. Sarah smiles. Come back and join me.
Baby, hey, with a woman's eyes, I can feel you watching him.
Hi, it's Rabbi Jenny from the Rabbi Jenny Show. Are you planning a wedding, baby naming, or bar bat mitzvah? Have you recently adopted a pet, bought a new home, or opened a new business? Do you have an important anniversary coming up and would like to renew your vows? Have you recently lost a loved one and need some compassion and care through this process? These are some of the many life events that touch our lives. It is at these moments that we need a special person for guidance and compassion and care to officiate and guide us through those moments. Call me, Rabbi Jenny, at 561-346-8207 to guide you and officiate these life events. 561-346-8207. Rabbi Jenny, for personal compassion and care and loving guidance for the important events of your life.
Do you know of anyone who lives with pain or has high blood pressure, diabetes, or asthma? Do seizures or any other types of illness run in the family? Then this message could be very important to you. RAIN International introduces Soul, a new energized drink that revitalizes and detoxifies naturally. Soul offers you the opportunity to feel better and get help with many illnesses that may have overtaken your body. Visit their website at myrainlife.com/God blessings and get all the information you need to let RAIN Solution heal your soul. If you want to talk to Soul, call 954-696-8330 and begin your steps to better health. RAIN International also has job opportunities that can change your life in 7 different categories. Call today and get a healthy body, a healthy mind, and create a healthy bank account. 954-696-8330. Call today and let's make it rain.
The after-school hours between 2 p.m. and 7 p.m. are when millions of children go home alone or are without adult supervision. Statistics have shown that during this time, gang involvement, teenage pregnancy, and drug use begins. For the past 15 years, For the Children, Inc., a place where children come first, has been a pioneer in providing quality after-school programming for underprivileged youth age 5 to 18 in Palm Beach County. Our children are our future. To ensure their success, they must have equal access to quality educational, personal growth, and leadership tools. For the Children, Inc. provides them all. Donate now to For the Children, Inc. at www.forthechildrenfirst.org.
This public service announcement for the Children, Inc. was brought to you by the law offices of Manjula Caladini, Esquire, concentrating in immigration law. www.immigrationassociates.net. You have been listening to Rabbi Jenny, who asks, are you ready to bring more light and love and joy into your life? A spiritually uplifting show that will change your world. Call in at 888-565-1470 or email at rabbijenny.com and share your thoughts with Rabbi Jenny. Now, back to our show.
Ready? Hi, it's Rabbi Jenny, and I'm talking very funny. I'm feeling very silly. I'm vacillating between ridiculously silly and very, very silly. I don't even know. My mood's all over the place, listeners. I'm just thrilled to be here. It's like, oh, can I just rest on this mic and talk to you all night long? Oh, that would be so great. Anyway, so make it happen. No, just kidding. No, I'm not kidding. Anyways, we are here talking about trust. We are here talking about trusting and patience and faith. And actually, I really am dying to talk to our guests a little bit. But I want to talk about this weird thing that I... You know what? I think I'll save that for the very, very end. So hang on for this thing I want to talk to you guys about. But let me introduce them. Are Tom, Dick, or Harry?
You're telling
Woo!
Me Rabbi Jenny will talk to any
Tom,
Dick, or Harry.
Any Tom!
Any Tom!
Any Dick!
Any Dick!
Thank you, Sister Amy, for that jingle. Welcome, Dr. Ian Silbert. I call him Dr. Ian for short. Psychologist, clinical director, all in all, cantor. I mean, I don't know. You've just done it all. Radio host.
A little bit.
A little bit of everything. Canadian. Don't tell anyone.
Still.
Still Canadian. It's important. It's important.
It is.
I think you're eternally Canadian. So what are you thinking about trust? Because I know your will spin more than most. So what's on your mind about this whole idea of trusting, and where are you on the line with trusting?
I think that, and I don't know, I think that it helps if the person who's telling you to trust, when right. you were talking about trust, actually practices what they preach,
right.
and they're not just giving you, you know, the hand, just trust me.
Right.
So for me, I think I have to figure that out. You help me with that. You're good about that.
Oh, yeah, well, you know, I trust. You know, I...
Well, it's not only that you trust, it's that, like you said, you put the time element into it. It calms people down. It's not an immediate reaction. It allows for a certain amount of thought.
Mm. Well, that's good, though. Trust is about time, because we want things to happen right away.
All the time.
Yeah,
that's why.
All the time.
I think the time part is something that most people don't realize, mm-hmm. because it actually, I think it's a scary emotion. I think, I think it could make people anxious. I think people think they're supposed to jump right into that mm-hmm. that kind of trust. And so, if they believe, if you can convince them, if they really just take a deep breath mm-hmm. and take the time and let X amount of the world go by, like you say, then consciously or unconsciously, they're going to go through this process of, I was going to say learning to trust, not necessarily learning to trust, but figuring out if they do trust in general.
It's an art. I think trust is like going to the gym. Like, I think you can, like, there should be like a special like gym for principals. You know, I'm going to go work out my trust today. I'm going to work out my patience today, you know, and you can actually practice it. Like, okay, I may not feel trustworthy, but I'm just going to trust today regardless.
I think you can actually practice it.
Yeah.
I don't think, again, a lot of people consciously practice it. But I think if you sat someone down mm-hmm. and said, because I say this all the time, mm-hmm. and maybe right now sitting here I realize what I'm saying.
Right.
I literally will look at people and say, I know you totally don't get this right now, but please trust the process.
Right.
And I'm saying the same thing. I'm saying trust, well, I'm saying trust me, but I'm saying trust time, trust what we're going to mm-hmm. do together, trust the journey, trust how it's going to go. Still with no promises of perfection and immediate gratification, but that concept of, you know, just slow down
mm-hmm.
and let it happen.
Well, and what we see, what we can imagine is limited by that moment. And so in like another 10 moments, we'll be able to imagine more by the amount of input we've had. And so if we think, you know, it's like, I think trust comes from this need to have A, like if it's a choice between A, B, and C, I want A now. Well, maybe C is the best thing for you. So it's like you have to wait because to realize that C is the best thing for you. But we're so stuck on A. You know, like our minds get stuck. And I know you talk a lot about OCD and that obsessive, you know, the mind being stuck on thoughts. Like one of the things I've watched you do with patients, and maybe you can explain this to the listeners, is that thought, you know, it's the thought and changing the way that you think. You could talk a little bit about that, because
I think if you figure out that it's going to be A instead of C or whatever, I think sometimes it's still a process, and I think sometimes it's still a trust, and I think sometimes it's still a slow down, and I think sometimes it's still we still have to work out mm-hmm. X amount,
absolutely.
And then a certain amount of intellect comes in, and so no, besides
it's
emotion,
true,
a certain
absolutely.
Amount of intellect comes in, and the client, the therapist, whomever says, oh, okay, well, I need to sort of compartmentalize this a little bit, and now this makes more sense with me.
Mm-hmm.
I talk a lot about OCD.
Mm-hmm.
Because I'm very into trying to help people who have a lot of the ruminating thoughts and just thinking so much and intrusive, unwanted thoughts that might not be based in reality. And those people, initially, they don't even trust themselves, okay? Later on, they're not even sure because they're so anxious whether to trust the thought or not. They don't want to, but then again, they want to.
It's the loudest voice.
It's the loudest.
It's the loudest one.
It's the loudest voice, perpetuated technically by yourself. And if you've even started, like I said, without a grounding of even trusting yourself.
Right.
Or would you call that instinct? I don't know.
I don't know. I think it's the fear brain. And that's, I think it's the fight or flight, the reptilian mind that makes a conclude, you know, it goes right there. And then there's a, like, a, I don't want to say it's a glitch, but I think we often become safely addicted to keeping that thought going. Like, it gives us a sense of some sort of control over the situation that you learn because, as a coping skill.
Absolutely, because at least if we keep that going, no matter how uncomfortable it feels, at least we know what to expect.
Right,
So we're too anxious and fear. Fear is the big word with anxiety. We're too anxious and fearful to try certain things, entertain certain things. And when I use the word entertain, I use the word try, well, then my brain goes back to trust and trust the process and trust myself. And but I do think, like you said, I think you have to work at it.
I do.
I think you have to be an active participant in this.
Well, and that recognizes this partnership that I'm always talking about. I mean, with the divine, with Hashem, with the universe, you know, that we are in a partnership. And you cannot, if you're two people are dancing, but one of them's like, I'm only dancing by myself, it doesn't work. You know, somebody who overleads a dance, it doesn't work. But if you look at life like dancing with the divine, dancing with your creator, it moves easier. But I think that we take the reins. If you've ever danced, I mean, which I have, and sometimes, you know, you have somebody who just overleads, and it's the same thing. It's like we're negating the rest of the world. Our mind just gets, it's like, no, it's just me, you know, not our heart, not our soul, not our body, not our experience, just this voice in our head.
I think it would be cool to actually, you know, put a bunch of people in a room and have them all dance and break it up into everything you just said so they could experience the feeling of everything you just said, not just blind trust Hashem or whatever, but the Hashem.
The feeling of being like you're not dancing. You know, and I think that we forget. I mean, the hardest thing to get somebody to realize, and I know you know this because you've talked about it, is that they're terrorizing themselves.
You are absolutely terrorizing yourself.
You know, it's like nobody else is doing this. You know, I terrorize myself. You know, like I'm willing admitting to it.
Well, you know what? It's incredibly mentally healthy when you get to that trust point where you are willing to admit that that is in fact what you're doing.
Right.
My favorite professor used to say we participate in our own victimization.
Mm.
And I think we do.
Absolutely.
And I think
Why do you think we do? Comfort? Safety? Familiar? Training? Genetics?
You know what? A little of everything.
Yeah,
I'm not gonna dispel genetics. I'm not gonna dispel that there's not some biological predisposition for people who can't stop thinking about something. I mean, that part's real too. But you also hear the phrase creatures of habit. So I just think you go into autopilot sometimes.
I think so.
And autopilot sometimes feels better than turning it off and actually flying the plane.
Yeah.
So, because you have to think when you're flying
the plane. Experience enough of the opposite before you want to do it. Like, I feel like there's a tipping point at some point where you realize it quicker and quicker and quicker.
And the opposite, people assume, always has to be bad. I don't think the opposite has to be bad.
No.
Or feel bad, you just have to, see, that's where the intellectual part of my thinking comes back in. You actually have to recognize that there's an opposite part, and that's okay.
Well, it's new. It's new.
It's new,
and the mind's like a computer. It's like new data. It freaks it out.
Uh-huh.
You know, it's like totally, totally new. And, you know, and this is like, this is heavy stuff, you know, with the thoughts that terrorize us. Where are the different areas of our life where we get glitched up? You know, I mean, everybody has their specific areas, you know. I would love to talk to you about this idea of generational terror, you know, coming from a Judaic background. We're both Jewish and we're both raised pretty Jewish, you know.
Pretty Jewish.
And, you know, but just anti-Semitism. Like the idea of how that can be, like sometimes I just know that it's not real, but I know it's there, you know, like it's weird. Like and I know that I was raised like that. Okay. Well,
I was just going to say, do you know that it's not real or do you want to believe that it's not real or is it a combination of everything?
Yeah.
Because it's just a hard thing to twirl around in our heads sometimes.
Absolutely. We'll be right back on Rabbi Jenny Show talking about Sarah and Trust with Dr. Ian. Hi, it's Rabbi Jenny from the Rabbi Jenny Show. Are you planning a wedding, baby naming, or bar bat mitzvah? Have you recently adopted a pet, bought a new home, or opened a new business? Do you have an important anniversary coming up and would like to renew your vows? Have you recently lost a loved one and need some compassion and care through this process? These are some of the many life events that touch our lives. It is at these moments that we need a special person for guidance and compassion and care to officiate and guide us through those moments. Call me, Rabbi Jenny, at 561-346-8207 to guide you and officiate these life events. 561-346-8207. Rabbi Jenny, for personal compassion and care and loving guidance for the important events of your life.
You say you need to lose weight for the holidays or just to stay healthy. Nothing seems to be working except frustration. The wait is over. Order your organic detox tea and resolution drops from the Weight Is Over company and start feeling better by shedding pounds. Not all detox systems are the same. Listen to those who have used the tea with fantastic results. Visit her website, totallifechanges.com/4219711 to get all the information you need to feeling better. Drink 2 cups a day and you too can lose 5 pounds in 5 days. Call today, 954-696-8330, and listen to testimonials about proper weight loss using the tea. Ask about the opportunity to earn $50,000 by Christmas with a Total Life Changes business opportunity. Call today, 954-696-8330, and change your life today.
The after-school hours between 2 p.m. and 7 p.m. are when millions of children go home alone or are without adult supervision. Statistics have shown that during this time, gang involvement, teenage pregnancy, and drug use begins. For the past 15 years, For the Children, Inc., a place where children come first, has been a pioneer in providing quality after-school programming for underprivileged youth age 5 to 18 in Palm Beach County. Our children are our future. To ensure their success, they must have equal access to quality educational, personal growth, and leadership tools. For the Children, Inc. provides them all. Donate now to For the Children, Inc. at www.forthechildrenfirst.org.
This public service announcement for the Children, Inc. was brought to you by the law offices of Manjula Caladini, Esquire, concentrating in immigration law. www.immigrationassociates.net. You have been listening to Rabbi Jenny, who asks, are you ready to bring more light and love and joy into your life? A spiritually uplifting show that will change your world. Call in at 888-565-1470 or email at rabbijenny.com and share your thoughts with Rabbi Jenny. Now, back to our show.
Hey, it's Rabbi Jenny. Welcome back. We're talking about trust with Dr. Ian and Sarah and the life of Sarah and how she represents learning to trust. And she represents all sorts of other stuff. One of the topics that Dr. Ian, you brought up during the break was the idea of blind trust.
Right.
And not, you know, what is that? And is there any such thing? And what do you think? Do you think there's blind trust, really?
I don't necessarily think that there's blind trust. I think somebody along the way invented it. I think you hear it a lot more in very strong religions or sects within religions, Orthodox Judaism or something, where it's sort of taught, you know, don't ask a lot of questions. Mm. I do believe we're not supposed to ask a lot of questions sometimes. Mm. I do believe also that maybe we don't have the capacity to understand some of the answers, so that maybe that's why we're not supposed to answer the questions. What I don't like is when someone says something or just trust me, and it's a blind trust way of saying it, and you know that this person really just wants you not to think. And we're telling everybody to think.
Well, and they want you to close your eyes to what you obviously see. You know, the idea of being blind is you can't see with your physical eyes. And I keep thinking of this whole idea of, like, we're so focused on what we see with our physical eyes, but there are these inner eyes. We have very sharp inner intuition. We have our eyes that seeing with our heart, seeing with our higher mind, that our eye doesn't necessarily reflect. Like, you, it's like somebody's asking you, oh, well, just don't look at that. You know, just don't notice that. You know?
Well, of course.
Right.
That's part of the blind trust too. You know, trust me, trust me, trust me. But like you said, but don't look at all those bad things that are in the chair
see,
over
right,
there.
Right.
Forget about that. I really didn't mean that, and it shouldn't have been left here. So,
what are the main areas that you think people have the most difficulty trusting in?
You would think it would be maybe in relationships with other people. I think you would think it would be in romantic, interpersonal, intense relationships with other people. The older I get, I do still think that we beat ourselves up, like you said. So I'm going to go back and think and say that a lot of it is ourselves.
Yeah, unworthiness.
And self-esteem,
right,
and what we've been told, and the fear and all those other things. So whereas someone might come into your office and sit down and you're going to work on trust issues between, you know, Mr. and Mrs., you might have to work with Mr. or Mrs. individually just on how to do that, on how to trust yourself, on, you know, let's practice a little bit here.
Yeah, and I see that in my own journey. You know, I always like to share, and I'll have you share a little bit from your own journey, but I know that self-esteem piece is key. Because sometimes I don't accurately see myself. I'm seeing myself through the past or through, you know, a lower vision that's caused by, I don't know, shame or emotions or mistakes or things in my past. And so I'm not accurately trusting based on the facts, even sometimes. Sometimes we're even warping the actual facts when it comes to self-esteem. You know, I'm always surprised, and maybe you're the same, as you could be sitting in front of someone exceptional, and they suffer from addiction or, you know, some sort of a trauma, and they just truly don't see themselves real, like in reality, you know. And so their whole life, their whole distrust is literally false, you know. So it is about, like, this, now that they'll see themselves, it'll be easier to trust that you're not going to starve and that you're capable and that, you know, that you'll be able to take care of yourself, you know.
And I think it's incredibly hard.
Mm-hmm.
Because when I talk about OCD, it really can be black and white. You really can teach people ways to eliminate thoughts. When you talk about trust, there are so many things firing in somebody's head at the exact same time, which is normal. But then just sort of piecing it apart or slowing it down a little bit is incredibly difficult, I think. I think it's incredibly difficult even to ask them to do that sometimes. So,
well, and it's all about having compassion. When you realize, like what you just said is very strong, that there are so many things. And so as human beings, we have to be kind and compassionate to ourselves and others. You know, like in situations where they're just not reacting the way we think is right or need to or have to. We have to realize the same crap, the same 50 things that are firing in our head are also firing in theirs. You know, and recognizing that and taking it to
level. So why are we so afraid to do that sometimes? Because we're having a hard time doing it.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah.
I always have a hard time doing it. I think that it's human.
It is human.
It's the dance. I think that the wisdom you get with age, if you leap off a few cliffs, like, you can learn nothing. I'm convinced it's not an age issue. You don't automatically become wise because you're 75. I mean, it's just, you have to have leapt off some cliffs. You have to have taken some chances because you have to dance, you know, like you have to take this dance. But I think there comes a time when it's better, but you always take bigger chances, do bigger things, create other things, you know, new projects, and have to take on bigger staffs, you know, and things.
And again, I think some of that is conscious. I think you think about mm-hmm. it. And I think some of it is just the way it's supposed to be, and it happens, and it's part of what you might call that person's journey and some degree of self-recognition of where I am in my journey right now might make it easier for me to embrace whatever that bigger, better, or just plain different
I think, you know, and I'm sitting here, like, my most difficult area, I believe, and is money. Trust.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like money. I mean, I know there's listeners listening, and the idea of abundance, reframing our thoughts about the universe, and that the nature of the universe, re-seeing things. Like, you don't think you're receiving what you're due, like Sarah. She wasn't receiving what she wanted. She didn't realize, like, she had traveled all this far. She had met all these people. Her and Abraham had this whole clan. They were building a whole thing. Then they were ready for Isaac. But she didn't look at all of that. She had decided that her riches only came this way. And I know that for me, I'll do that. Like, I won't notice, like, my son and my plants and my house and my dog. And I'll go, well, I'm not making enough money. I mean, like, this is crazy. Why am I always worried? Why are these bills always coming? Well, bills come. You have to light the house. Like, that's what happens, you know?
I agree. It's funny because I know you. So I agree. But I also think that you have this kind of power to set some of that anxiety aside and not necessarily laissez-faire, but what will be, what will be.
Mm.
And everything will work out the way it is supposed to work mm-hmm. out. I don't mind when people say that.
Right.
That doesn't bother me, really. I don't really like it is what it is. I don't like a lot of those things. But I mean, you know, that it gives me a little play when they say everything will work out. Why? Because they're not really telling me anything, but they're causing me to actually think of what the heck I got to do to make everything work out. So,
well, it's like that saying from this movie. Did you see The Best Exotic Marigold Hotel?
No.
You have to see this movie. It's delicious. It's with Maggie Smith. It's with Judy Dench. All these fantastic English actors,
Wow. Classic
actors, and the saying, you know, if everything's all right in the end, if it's not all right, it's not the end. And I just, it's true. You know, I was, somebody also was talking about, you know, the difference between birth and death. Birth, you're screaming, you're crying, it's messy. Death, peaceful, we lay, it's fine. You know, it's like, we have this really warped way of looking at our lives that almost, like, terrorizes ourselves. That seems to be the word for the day. How do I do that? So where could you work on trust more, Dr. Ian, you think?
Me?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yes. You know I like to do that.
Yeah, no. That's why Jenny never tells me what the subject is, you know, until 1 second before the light goes on. I almost want to say I can work on more getting rid of not trusting first than I can work on trusting. I don't know if that's a good answer. That's kind of my OCD answer. It is. It's my OCD answer. I got to get rid of something that doesn't make sense to me in my head first
right.
to go to the next thing that makes sense to me that I'm not going to go crazy about, that I'm going to work on.
Mm.
And it's probably people in general.
Well, I know you're a singer and you're a musician.
Right.
And how do you feel when you're doing that? Do you trust? Do you feel completely connected 100%?
With absolutely everybody, no matter how good they are or bad, standing around me singing along.
So maybe doing more of that consciously. Almost like people think meditating is like sitting and oming, but like for musicians, meditating, I believe, is building that conscious connection. And if it's singing, that makes you feel absolutely 100% sure that everything's okay, then, you know, we need to do more of that. I mean, I have, you know, the same, you know, I'm speaking to you, I'm speaking to me, I'm speaking to our listeners. What is the thing that you do? Is it gardening? Is it singing? Is it writing? What is the thing that you
do? It's probably playing and singing. It's probably taking more time for myself to do those things by myself. Not that I don't want everybody around me, but there still is a different feeling when you're by yourself and people say lost in the moment. I don't know if you're lost, but all of a sudden you turn around and 3 hours have gone by and you realize how wonderful you feel. And you know that on Saturday you can do 3 more hours and you're mad because you didn't do 3 more hours on Saturday.
Wow.
So,
and what kind of a world would have that and the untrustworthy nightmare that we create for ourselves? And that's, I think that's the pain, the human pain. Like we live in that. So it's like we know what we know. And then, I don't know. Like
it sounds really easy, right? It sounds intellectually really simple. Go back, sit down and do this again for 3 hours. It felt good.
Trust is hard, listeners. It's hard. Dr. Ian, you'll hang out for the jam in the last segment. All right. This is Rabbi Jenny. The after-school hours between 2 p.m. and 7 p.m. are when millions of children go home alone or are without adult supervision. Statistics have shown that during this time, gang involvement, teenage pregnancy, and drug use begins. For the past 15 years, For the Children, Inc., a place where children come first, has been a pioneer in providing quality after-school programming for underprivileged youth aged 5 to 18 in Palm Beach County. Our children are our future. To ensure their success, they must have equal access to quality educational, personal growth, and leadership tools. For the Children, Inc. provides them all. Donate now to For the Children, Inc. at www.forthechildrenfirst.org.
This public service announcement for the Children, Inc. was brought to you by the law offices of Manjula Calladini, Esquire, concentrating in immigration law. www.immigrationassociates.net.
Do you know of anyone who lives with pain or has high blood pressure, diabetes, or asthma? Do seizures or any other types of illness run in the family? Then this message could be very important to you. RAIN International introduces Soul, a new energized drink that revitalizes and detoxifies naturally. Soul offers you the opportunity to feel better and get help with many illnesses that may have overtaken your body. Visit their website at myrainlife.com/God blessings and get all the information you need to let RAIN Solution heal your soul. If you want to talk to Soul, call 954-696-8330 and begin your steps to better health. RAIN International also has job opportunities that can change your life in 7 different categories. Call today and get a healthy body, a healthy mind, and create a healthy bank account. 954-696-8330. Call today and let's make it rain.
Hi, it's Rabbi Jenny from The Rabbi Jenny Show. Are you planning a wedding, baby naming, or bar bat mitzvah? Have you recently adopted a pet, bought a new home, or opened a new business? Do you have an important anniversary coming up and would like to renew your vows? Have you recently lost a loved one and need some compassion and care through this process? These are some of the many life events that touch our lives. It is at these moments that we need a special person for guidance and compassion and care to officiate and guide us through those moments. Call me, Rabbi Jenny, at 561-346-8207 to guide you and officiate these life events. 561-346-8207. Rabbi Jenny, for personal compassion and care and loving guidance for the important events of your life.
You have been listening to Rabbi Jenny, who asks, are you ready to bring more light and love and joy into your life? A spiritually uplifting show that will change your world. Call in at 888-565-1470 or email at rabbijenny.com and share your thoughts with Rabbi Jenny. Now, back to our show.
Essentially. Hi, it's Rabbi Jenny. Welcome back. We're talking about trust today. I believe it is time, though, for the Ridiculous Joy Jar Challenge. Joy!
joy, 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 joy. It's Adeline Goldberg-Stein, and it's time for the Rabbi Jenny Ridiculous Joy Jar Challenge.
Hi, who's on the phone?
Hi, it's Chef Elisa.
Chef Elisa?
Yes.
Chef Elisa, I love it. I love it. I can't wait to hear what you do, Chef Elisa. Do you know about the Ridiculous Joy Jar Challenge?
No, I don't, but I have a good feeling I'm about to.
Okay, what you need to do for me, Chef Elisa, is you need to name 10 things as fast as you can that make you ridiculously joyful. And when you do that, you will get to promote everything about you that you would like to on the Rabbi Jenny Show. You ready?
Oh, I'm ready.
You got 10?
Definitely.
Okay, here we go. Ready? Ready, Chef Elisa? Go.
Hearing. Love having hearing. Love my cat waking up in the morning and seeing them. My daughter, my work, my past struggles and challenges, my clients, my car. Technology, 2015. The opportunities that are available. Have I hit 10 yet?
You have. You actually hit 11. Ding, 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 ding. You win the Ridiculous Joy Jar Challenge on the Rabbi Jenny Show, and you get to promote anything you want. So please, Chef Elisa, tell me about you and who you are and what you do.
Well, thank you. I have a catering business. It's called Chef Elisa's Catering.
Okay.
And I do event catering. So I do bar mitzvahs and weddings and holiday parties and events anywhere from 30 guests up to 500 guests.
That's fantastic.
So I do kosher style
events. Yay.
I also have a personal chef style service. So if someone does need a very specific menu, we do have chefs and resources and myself that we can fill those slots and actually cook in kosher homes. So we can bring
wonderful.
On. Yeah, we bring everything current, you know, in its packaging, nothing open. We learn the rules and the ways of the kitchen, so what's scary and what's neat, so that we can navigate properly and bring in all the right types of disposable equipment to keep everything
wonderful.
All organized.
It's the hardest part, let me tell you.
Well, that organization's everything. It's all about the trust, right? It's all about
all
the
about the trust. I love it. You're quoting me. This is fabulous. Okay, so I want to ask you a question. It's a very serious question. Are you listening, Chef Elisa?
I am.
Is cooking your passion?
Yes, cooking is my passion.
And did you find it? Did you know that always, or did you find it later? I mean,
I found it when I was 13.
Oh my gosh!
Really young. Yeah, I was really, really fortunate to be able to come into a situation with a really supportive mom.
Oh, I love that.
I know. And she, she realized that I had a gift for cooking,
mm-hmm.
And it was actually come through struggle. My parents divorced, and mm-hmm. I took on that duty, and she was so grateful and so much praise for the delicious food that we were blessed, and she found me a tutor at this really ridiculously young age of 13.
How awesome
and
is that?
Amazing.
So what's your favorite? What's your favorite thing to cook? Because I want to tell the listeners how to get in touch with you next. So what's your favorite thing to cook? Very quickly, and then let's give them a phone number where they can reach you.
I'm going to say event parties, pass hors d'oeuvre formats, where I get to do a whole global menu with Asian fusion, Caribbean, kosher style, just really mix it up with potato pancakes and smoked salmon, and then hit it with some tuna tartare on wonton.
So how do we get in touch with you, Chef Elisa?
Okay, so I have a website, which is chefelisascatering.com. I have 27 five-star reviews on Thumbtack, so if you're a Thumbtack user, you can find me there. And my phone number is 954-288-6227.
One more time.
954-288-6227.
Okay, Chef Elisa, it has been a joy to speak with you.
Thank you. It's been a pleasure and a blessing. Thank you.
Thank you so much for calling the Rabbi Jenny Show. Have a beautiful, blessed day.
I will.
Or evening.
Too,
oh my gosh, it's dark out. Okay, have a beautiful evening. Okay.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Okay. Oh, the chair phone sounds good. Now I'm hungry. You hungry?
I'm hungry.
Okay. I think, you know, we're it's time for the Jenny Jam. I don't know. We're going to go right into it, I think.
Yo, yo, yo. Jam. Oh, jam.
For Sarah.
Rabbi Jenny Jam. Jam.
Yes. Ooh, I'm kind of getting lost here. Here we go. Ready? There we go. The good will come, so we're told. It's time that takes the fool off road. So hold on tight and let it come. In waking hours of hot, hot sun. The price be paid by nights and days. The time it makes to doubt away. So hold on tight and stay on course. And not lose faith and make it worse. You got shine. Stay in power. She got shine. Wait for it. She got shine. Stay in power. She got shine. Wait for it. Nothing's happening, not at all. Become distracted and chase that ball that bounces quick inside your head and follow it to feed the den. The heart, it beats in step with time. It knows it all will work out fine. So hold on tight and stay on course and not lose faith and make it worse. You got shine. Stay in power. She got shine. Wait for it. She got shine. Stay in power. She got shine. Wait for it. The price be paid by days and nights. It's time that makes us doubt what's right. So hold on tight and stay on course. Do not lose faith and make it worse. She got shine. Stay in power. She got shine. Wait for it. All right, all right. I got to talk about something. But first I want to read a quote. It's a quote by Hafiz. He is my favorite poet. He's very delicious. If you've never read him, you must. And it says, "And still, after all this time, the sun never says to the earth, 'You owe me.' Look what happens with a love like that. It lights up the whole sky." It's just that partnership between the natural things in life. It's easy. You know, I heard this thing which really gets on my nerves. This is one quote I got to share with you because we're talking about trust, but it's a concept that's starting to get on my nerves. There are certain things, and it's grinding at me. People say, you know, pain is the pathway to peace. I have to tell you, Meshuggah quote, I'm done with it. I'm throwing it out. I'm done. Because pain is not the pathway to peace. The pathway is peaceful. Pain happens on the path. You know, the path is always peaceful. But pain happens. You don't have to go through pain to become peaceful. That's the victim in us. That's the belief. I want you to get this, listeners. I want you to get that the path is always peaceful. Painful things will happen. But if you rest in the fact that you're on the path, that you're always connected to something magical and divine, that you're always expanding and it's happening for you, then you will be more peaceful and you will trust more. I adore you. It's Rabbi Jenny. I will talk to you deliciously next Wednesday. Have a beautiful week full of lots of trust. Work on it. Go to the trust gym.
You have been listening and lighting up your life with Rabbi Jenny. Join us next week for another session of love, light, and joy as Rabbi Jenny takes life to the next level. Are you ready? Rabbi Jenny says the time is now.
The opinions expressed on the preceding sponsor.